It's massive. If you missed it the first three times, it's magnanimous. But for the KZN Science collectively, they currently must feel small. AmaZulu, Arrows and Maritzburg United all congregating in the bottom half of the table. Will the Princess Makoko be the turning juncture for them? Hello from a windy KwaMashu. Around five MBC fixtures, live and direct, in the grand of high definition, as only your World of Champions can bring it to you. Well, a small crowd has started to, well, swell, given the early game that we saw a bit in the day. It was Highlands Park who took on Orlando Pirates that saw them win 1-0. Watch out for the wind as well, as I mentioned. Looks like Nkosikona Dube is already thrust quickly into the action. He want to put himself in the box. He's the one who will have to really to get on the ball of that. And 32 seconds on the clock. Oh, ho, ho. That's how you start in KZN Derby. Forget that they've lost the previous four games. Forget they've not kept clean sheets. Forget that they've only scored three goals in four games. They've just scored in 32 seconds. Ouch. Now it's Dumisa flashes it across to the box, and the defender really almost gifting a chance to his opposition. I can tell you that skipper Mwikuhle Hlongwane absolutely livid at how that ended up.
When you think of Thomas, how is he going to sleep tonight? He's going to be tired because this boy has been running riots all around him.
And he sits on a yellow card. He's a passer, or got enough up. Because it wait on it, it does, as the keeper comes out well off his line. Hlongwane thought he was in up until a crucial moment as he's about to pull the trigger, but was thwarted by a last-ditch tackle. Don't start it from Makomo speeding off his line. He had to from the pass.
You see the wind playing effect there, and Bayanda Komo not really reading the wind, and the ball holds up on the wind.
Thomas's mistake. Ukunena's cross is met with absolute disdain from Nkosikona Dube. The most minimal of celebrations. Two assists for Linukutle Kunene. Two goals for Golden Arrows. How about fun? I best turned it on a bossing at this KZN Derby double.
It's that young man again, Kunene, chasing a lost cause with Thomas. Thomas trying to be clever and losing the ball to Dube, to Kunene.
Thomas Khan, then to clever footwork of Mbata. That right-hand side is working for the team of choice as they're rifling the ball, and they indeed get one back. They're threatened a couple of times. Golden Arrows couldn't shut down the door on the left-hand side, and they finally put money in the bank with the team of choice after not profiting with the previous attempts. Komo's dream of a clean sheet in five games now continues.
Golden Arrows again, they can't keep a clean sheet, Temba. And this has been their downfall this season.
Oh, Thomas clips the ball over, and is that a dive or is that a penalty? A referee approaching the crime scene. You've got Komo who's planted his face into the ground. Hlongwane looking guilty. The referee just doing what referees do, assessing the situation and taking his time. Kunena also seems to be taking strife.
The keeper didn't get the ball. You call that a penalty? Ooh, for my eyes,
looks
that's
like
a penalty
there, Tabo. Keeper did not get the ball at all.
Contact is there.
Yep.
If it was outside of the box, he will give it as a foul. Why not give it as a foul? I mean, even if it's the 90th minute.
Well, for Coach Siam Dluli back to the drawing board. Vusumisi Vilakazi still can't manage a smile, but the likes of Dube congratulating his teammate Wandile Ndiseli. He played well alongside Siamonga Ngobo. For much of the game, they were comfortable. As confirmation in the first minute, or just under a minute of play, was Nala Dube in the 66th minute. Zondi with a bit of reprieve, but not enough for Maritzburg United.